career in Moscow in 1984, and I lived here for 2 years, 1984 and 1985, during which I spent 1 year learning the Russian language, and the rest of the 1 year I was working as a very young diplomat, about your age, or maybe slightly older. I was 26, I think, in the embassy. Since then I have traveled to many countries. I have done different kinds of jobs, some which have been difficult, some not so difficult. But I have come back now towards the end of my career back to Russia. This is my first visit to Kursk, and I know that you are situated in a very, very interesting part of Russia, which is close to the Ukrainian border. It's also close to Moscow. I have come here only because I wanted to meet all of you. And I realized that you are a very important part of not just the university here, but you are a very important part of my responsibility as ambassador, because as long as you are an Indian citizen, I feel that I am responsible for you, for your welfare, for your security, and for your well-being. Now, the reason I am saying all this is, I have introduced myself to you. With me I have my delegation members. Abhishek Vesh is the head of our science and technology wing. Shashwati Day is from our commercial section. She is a recent entrant to the embassy. Abhishek is from Uttar Pradesh. And Shashwati is from Odisha. And Zainab is, of course, my interpreter. So I have introduced me, myself. I have introduced my delegation. Now that leaves me to find out who you are. And I would like all of you to help me understand who you are. So I don't want each one of you to introduce yourselves, because that will take the full day. But maybe I can ask a few questions. And that way we get to know each other better before I start speaking. Is that okay? So, the most obvious question which one Indian asks another Indian is, where are you from? So that's more or less obvious. But let me ask you, if I ask you which cities you're from, I'll get 100 replies. So let me ask you, are you largely from which part of, which region of India? The south, the north? I think the south has it. The south is certainly looks like it. But who are the people from, say, the north of the Vindhyas? The north of the Vindhyachals? So you are clearly a minority. So if you are from the north, then so how many of you are Hindi speaking? North?
All of us.
There are no Punjabis here.
You don't take me.
So when it comes to the south, then I presume a lot of you are from Tamil Nadu?
Yes!
Kerala?
Yes!
You? Andhra? So, I think I should speak English, because everyone will understand my language. I don't know Tamil, so I don't want to try that, but I'll speak in English. So that's very interesting, that's very good. year for periods ranging from 1 year to 5 years. Is that correct? Six. So how many of you are have been here for say 5 years? So the rest of you are freshers. Do they have a concept of freshers here?
No, we.
Is there such a concept that you come as a freshman and
sorry.
You're treated like a kid by the seniors? How many of you know Russian? So well, thank you very much. That's very useful. So, and it's also nice to, I must say, as an Indian, to see that there is a good, healthy mix of both girl students and male students. So that's very, very encouraging. All of you, I presume, stay either in hostel or in apartments. I don't know what is the mix. How many of you are actually in hostels? And how many? So most of you are in hostels. So do you live in single rooms or double rooms or?
Three-seater room.
So how many years in apartments? So you learned. Have your parents been guiding you how to cook? Always full of who's winning, who's losing. But what is something we all have to be very proud of as Indians is the fact that despite the big population, despite all the difficulties in India, we still manage to conduct elections. We still manage to have free and fair elections. And everyone in India accepts the results of these elections. And the winners accept their victory, the losers accept their defeat. There is no conflict, there is no violence, and there is a peaceful transfer of government from one party to another. This is a big, I think, tribute to the maturity of our country and our democracy. And this is something which all of us, I think, should be very, very proud of. It is not easy to manage. You know, when you travel out of India, you see how there are so many countries which are in such difficulties in different parts of the world, in states of crisis. But in India, we have managed to deal with our own problems. We have managed to live and lead a fairly successful democracy. This is not easy. If you look at the fact that we have a population of 1.3 billion people. 1.3 billion people is, by the way, equal to the population of the entire African continent. So if you think about who we are actually equal to 54 countries of Africa. That is the number of countries in Africa where about 1 billion people live. And in contrast to that, we are just one country with 29 states and such a large and diverse population. And sitting here in front of me, and I'm sure that you meet each other, you know what I mean when I say that we are a diverse country. So it's something that we need to be very proud of as Indians. Also, we are one of the very few countries in the world, few economies in the world, which is growing so rapidly at 7% a year. Most of the advanced European countries, the United States, even parts of Southeast Asia, Japan, their growth rates are between 0 to 1% a year. China, the growth rate has fallen to about 6%. In Russia, they have just entered a positive rate of growth this year. So in comparison to all those countries, if we are growing at 7%, it means that there is a very major and dramatic transformation that is underway in our country. And life for Indians is changing. So when life in India changes, and changes so fast, naturally, there will be, society will be disturbed because the people who are at the bottom of the rung, bottom of the ladder, have suddenly begun to see more opportunities for themselves. Are you understanding me or am I being too theoretical? So there is a social transformation that is taking place in our country. And what is even more unique about India is the fact that we are the youngest country in the world. So if you think about it, 65%, which means more than 700 million Indians, are below the age of 35, which means they're your generation. And if you have a population of that magnitude, which is young, which is ambitious, which is aspirational, which wants a better life, I mean, here you are. The fact that you are here, what does it mean? It means you, and more importantly your parents, wanted you to have a better life than they had, which is why you are here. And that shows that if we have this young generation of Indians who are constantly trying to improve their lives, it will have an impact on the entire country. If all of you go back to the country and contribute to its growth and its success, then the country as a whole benefits. So we should understand what we are as a nation. We should understand that we are moving very fast forward. And in this process of rapid change, if we find there are hiccups, there are difficulties, it's part and parcel of a process of rapid change. The second part of what I wanted to just briefly mention to you was, and it is not directly related to what you are doing here, and I will come to that at the end of my remarks about you, about the university and so on. But before that, I just wanted to also give you a glimpse of some of the other aspects you may or may not have heard about in your day-to-day life. So the second aspect is about what the relationship is between India and Russia. I mean, what is the nature of our relationship, both between the two governments, between the peoples, between our two societies. You probably would have heard or learnt in school when you were studying that soon after we became independent in 1947, one of the first countries in the world which came to India's help was the Soviet Union. And the Soviet Union at that time helped us to build our steel plants, our dams, our teacher, educate our engineers. They helped to establish the IIT in Mumbai. There was a whole area of cooperation that was conducted with Soviet assistance. So that is the tradition of our relationship, even with today's modern Russia. And the relationship, therefore, between India and Russia is concrete. It goes into real areas of cooperation. Whether it is science and technology, whether it is even trade. You know, there was a time in the 1980s when Indian tea was the most popular tea in Russia or in the Soviet Union. Indian films, Raj Kapoor, Mithun Chakravarti, all these are names which I'm sure you hear when you go on the streets. I don't know why they like Mithun Chakravarti, but they do. I could never understand it. Raj Kapoor is okay, but you know. So they like Indian films. They love Indian dance. I mean, I have seen Russians, you know, dancing Bharatnatyam and Kathak, Kuchipudi and Odissi and so on. So there is a genuine desire. They like yoga. Yoga has become increasingly popular, especially among the younger generation. So that's on the cultural field. A lot of Russians go to Goa for holidays. I'm sure you must have seen. Why are you laughing? Well, they go to Goa. They like the beaches, they like the sand, they like the sandy. We are now increasingly trying to promote Kerala as a tourist destination. How many of you have Kerala? Yeah. So, you know, that's Ayurveda and Kerala and so on is a very attractive destination. So we are trying to promote that. Then on the other side, we have a lot of cooperation, very, very extensive cooperation in the area of energy, particularly nuclear energy. I mean, all of you who are from Tamil Nadu would know about Kudankulam. And in Kudankulam we have six nuclear power units that have been set up with Russian assistance. And each unit is producing 1000 megawatts. So we have already unit 1 and unit 2 which are running. So 2000 megawatts of energy is already being supplied to the grid from Kudankulam. And we are having, we are planning another 4 units. So nuclear is a big area of cooperation. Military technical cooperation is also very big. Russia today, you may know, I don't know whether you know or you do not know, but the broad average statistic is that 70% of India's defense equipment is of Russian origin. So think about it, 70% of all our defense equipment is from Russia, which means you're talking of the Air Force, the Army, the Navy, is all from Russia. So 70% is a very, very large number. Now, to reach this figure has taken time, it has taken a lot of hard work, it's taken 3, 4, 5 decades. And in this process, a lot of Russian technical experts have traveled to India, a lot of Indian technical experts have visited Russia. Even as we speak today, there are a fairly large number of Indian experts and Russian experts living in our countries in this area. So, all this put together means that we have also, in overall terms, a very good political relationship. Today, if in Russia you tell someone you are from India, most likely you will be warmly welcomed. Similarly, if a Russian goes to India and says, I'm from Russia, I'm a Russian, he would be warmly welcomed. So this is a very unique aspect of our relationship. This year we are also celebrating the 70th anniversary of our diplomatic relations. We established our diplomatic relations with Russia on the 13th of April, 1947. That is, remember, it was before we became independent. So at that time, when we were still under British rule, the rulers of India decided that we must establish relations with the Soviet Union. So on 13th April, that is next month, we will celebrate the 70th anniversary. Now, as part of this, what we are planning to do is to have events all over the country. Now, Russia is a big country, you know, it is. I first did some calculation and I took out the map of Russia and the map of India and I compared the two. In geographical terms, Russia is 5 times as big as India. So, if it is 5 times as big as India, you can imagine how big it is. And when you're driving around Kursk, you can see that there are vast open spaces and so on. So, we celebrate this year, we plan to organize different events through the entire year. And here, I would like to have your cooperation. We would like to have some events maybe also in Kursk. If you think it is a good idea, if some of you can volunteer and if you have an association and the association comes and says, look, we would like to do something as part of this, then we would be, as the embassy, happy to work with you, to collaborate with you. But the initiative should come from you. So is there a president of the, is there an association? I believe you have an association.
Yes.
So is there a president or something?
Yes.
Is he here?
Yes.
No, you are the president.
Yes.
So, is he elected or was he forced upon you?
Elected.
So how did he win? I mean, what was special about him? So if the association wants to do an event from now till December, we would be happy to work, the embassy would be happy to work with you. And we can think of doing something where, you know, we do a cultural program or we do a small film festival and things like that. We can think about it and we can work with you, the embassy, we can work. The other important thing about this year, as far as our relations is concerned, is that our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, is expected to visit Russia in the first week of June. And this is a big event. Yeah, and we are all very excited. He is coming to St. Petersburg for the Economic Forum. The St. Petersburg is one of the biggest. It is the biggest economic expo of Russia, and he is the chief guest. So it's a great privilege for India, and he will be participating in the main event of the forum, and he will be sharing the stage with the President of Russia, President Putin, and this is going to happen in the first week of June. So all of you must ensure that you watch, it will be transmitted live, so you must watch it on television. I have attended last year, the forum last year, it's a grand event, so it will be very, very important for all of you to watch your Prime Minister come and speak. Now I want to just come and talk to you a little bit about the embassy. Now I know that officers from the embassy have been visiting Kursk regularly and have met you all, which is a good thing. We do it deliberately. Like I said, we treat you as part of our family. But we also treat each and every one of you as a representative of India. So when you go out on the streets, when you go to bars and pubs, are you allowed?
Yes.
You go to restaurants?
Yes.
So they ask you, you're an Indian, so when you're walking around, remember that when you cross the borders of India and you are living in a foreign country, apart from learning medicine, you are also a walking representative of India. So, people ask you, so are you from India? They say, oh yeah, you're from India, do you wear a sari? Do you wear saris? I don't know whether the ladies wear saris outside. Are you allowed to go to you?
Okay.
So, all of you are, part of the family, but also representatives of India. So I want you to keep that in mind, that your behavior, how you deal with each other, how you deal with your local friends, colleagues, people you meet in your daily lives, all this matters. Because they will associate your behavior with the behavior of how an Indian would behave. So it's important for you to keep this in mind, that you must keep the dignity and the pride of India in your mind. Don't do anything which will bring disgrace, harm to your country. Because you are on your own, so apart from being true to yourself, apart from being true to your parents and your families, you must also be true and patriotic to your country. So keep that in mind and ensure that you follow the rules, follow the law, because your reputation matters. Remember that there were people before you who were in this university, there will be people after you who will come. And so over a period of time, Indian students develop a certain reputation, and you should, when you leave this university, you should be satisfied that you have left behind a good reputation, so that your future batches who come, they walk into a situation where they are welcomed. We do not want a situation where the university authorities only say, look, we don't want Indian students. We don't want that. You want people to say, I want more Indian students. Right. Now, how would you say that? You would, only that will happen if you are show yourself to be good citizens of Kursk and good students of the university. So now in the embassy we have an education wing which deals with all students. We have about 6,000 plus students, Indian students studying all over Russia. Kursk of course is, you constitute a very big chunk. We have another large number of Indian students in Kazan. I went and visited Kazan a few months ago, again in the medical university. So in totality, we have about 6,000 Indian students, or 6,000 plus in Russia. So we have an education wing in the embassy. We have a visa wing, we have a consular wing. The job of the education wing is to take care of you, to look at your problems, to see how we can solve problems if you get into any difficulty. Basically, they are available for rendering any kind of help that you want. So keep that in mind. The visa and the consular section is available to give you basic services, passport services, visa guidance, any other problems or emergencies that may happen. So visa and consular services are available for you. Now we have a website, the embassy has a website, which is bilingual, it's both in English and in Russian. We have a section for the education wing. We have a section for the visa wing. Look at it. Familiarize yourself with it. In the education section, we have put a lot of FAQs just to help you, help incoming students. And treat the embassy as a friend. Someone you can go to, someone you can approach. And the embassy will always be there to render you help of any kind that you want. Don't feel shy or don't feel hesitant to contact the embassy. That brings me to the last part of what I want to say, and here I want to, which is your life. And here I want to begin by thanking the rector and the administration of this university for inviting me today to this university, for their extremely warm hospitality, for all the excellent arrangements that have been made for my visit. I know that in the morning I visited a very, very high technology center, hospital for oncology. I have done some research about the university before I came, and clearly it is one of the good universities of Russia. It has been recognized by the Medical Council of India, and that list of those universities recognized by the NCI is on our website. So you are actually, all of you are eligible to take your exams for the NCI. And the fact that so many of you are here is by itself a good statement of confidence in the university. So I think we should join in a round of applause for the rector and for the faculty. So what you're studying here is very important. All of you are training to be doctors. India needs doctors. I mean, we have an acute shortage of good quality doctors. And I have absolutely no doubt that when you go back to India, you will be in great demand, because we have a severe and acute shortage of good doctors. So while you are here, make the best of it. Try and maximize your experience as a student and extract whatever you can from the university. Your parents have sent you, they have spent money, they have sent you away, you are living separately from them. So you must do justice to all this, and you must study hard so that when you go back after 5 or 6 years, you feel satisfied that, yeah, I think I took the right decision to come here, that I have learned what I had to learn, and I'm going back ready to face my new life in India as a doctor. I have not seen your hostels. Or how you live, but I am told that you have reasonably good accommodation, and all I want to say to you is, as I mentioned to you, make sure you live here as good students and as good citizens of India and as good residents of Kursk. This is important. If you have difficulties of any kind relating to your education, relating to your stay, you should feel free to contact us. And we, of course, have full faith and confidence in the university administration, in the rector's personal leadership of the university. I know that the university has grown rapidly during this time. I have had a discussion with him, and he has clearly told me that he is very interested in continuing to expand and increase its cooperation with India. And that is a good thing which I am hearing from him, and I think the credit goes to you. Obviously, as an Indian, I would like all of you to be topping in your class. I hope you are, don't embarrass me. I'm sure you are. So, I would like all of you to do well, to excel in your classes, to show everyone else that Indians have brains, and we are pretty good. I'm sure you'll agree. And that we are second to no one in the world. So that reputation also has to be preserved, and I am confident that you're doing that. But apart from that, also learn to enjoy life. I mean, life is not just about studying. I mean, there are things to do outside of class, and you should explore the city, you should develop your personalities, you should engage in any activity that you like, develop your overall personality, whether it is in the area of culture, in the area of sport, if you like literature. I mean, there are so many things to do. If you like traveling, you must allow yourself to develop. This is while in college, you must use this opportunity to the maximum. And that includes everyone sitting on the back benches. So, this is broadly what I thought I would convey to you. There are, I know, other nationalities also here. So again, it's a very unique opportunity that you are getting to interact with foreign cultures. I mean, you could actually be studying medicine back home, where you would not have this opportunity. But here today, sitting in Kursk, you have this opportunity. Kursk is not, is very centrally located. It is close to Moscow. And from Moscow, you get connected to Delhi, to India. So it is reasonably well connected, better than many other parts of Russia. Now, what I would do, I think I would probably end here, but I would definitely like to hear some comments or questions from you, if you have, so that we can finish. We have about 5 or 10 minutes. Oh, okay, so, okay. और ये एक ऐसा एक जिंदगी का एक होता है फेज जिसमें पढ़ाई भी जरूरी है लेकिन थोड़ा एक जिंदगी का मजा लेना भी जरूरी है क्योंकि इसी तरह आदमी एक पूरा आदमी बनता है और डॉक्टरी तो आप लोग कर ही रहे हैं और हिंदुस्तान जाके आप बढ़िया डॉक्टर बनेंगे मेहनत करेंगे अच्छी तनख्वाह मिलेगी आपको लेकिन जब तक आप लोग यहाँ हैं ऐसे अच्छे अच्छे काम करिए जिससे कि आपको भी अच्छा लगे और जो आपके साथ रहते हैं चाहे वो रूसी हो चाहे और देशों के हो उनको भी अच्छा लगे उनको याद रहे कि यहाँ पे आप आए थे यहाँ पे हिंदुस्तानी छात्र छात्राएँ आई थी मैंने अच्छा काम किया अच्छे दोस्तें बनाए दोस्ती हुई व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप बने इंटरनेट बना ग्रुप ग्रुप चैट हुआ तो ये सब बड़ा सा शगुन होना चाहिए और मैं चाहता हूँ कि जो हमारे त्यौहार हैं चाहे होली है या दिवाली है या ईद है ये लोग आप अच्छी तरह मनाएं 15 अगस्त आने वाला है वो भी आपको मनाना चाहिए तिरंगा झंडा लेके तो थोड़ा सा अपने दिल में हिंदुस्तान की जगह जरूर रखिए हिंदुस्तान को बिल्कुल भूलने का कोई मतलब ही नहीं है और वापस वहीं जाना है वही हमारी धरती है वही हमारी माता है तो मैं चाहूँगा कि इस तरह आप लोग सब अपने निजी जिंदगियों में खूब तरक्की करें अच्छी सेहत और अच्छी पढ़ाई, यही एक बहुत बढ़िया आपका योगदान होगा अपनी अपनी तरफ, अपने पेरेंट्स की तरफ, अपने भाई बहनों की तरफ, अपने दोस्तों की तरफ, क्योंकि सबकी निगाहें, सबकी आंखें इंडिया में आपके ऊपर हैं। आप लोग अपने माता पिताओं से रोज बात करते हैं या हर दूसरे दिन या तीसरे दिन? रोज हफ्ते में एक बार, ये बहुत बात तो करते हैं। तो इन इन सब चंद शब्दों के साथ मैं फिर से दोबारा आप सबको बहुत बहुत बधाई देना चाहता हूँ, बहुत आशीर्वाद देना चाहता हूँ। और आपको देख के मुझे बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है कि मैं इतने सारे प्यारे युवा भारतीयों के साथ बैठा हूँ, और मैं चाहता हूँ कि इसी तरह आप मुस्कुराते रहें, हंसते रहें और हमारी देश की तरक्की करें और हमारे देश को और आगे आप लोग बढ़ाएँ।